start facing the bar.
Here at Gulfshore Ballet in Fort Myers.
And flex coup de pied, and out.
Every move is taught to carry the same grace and elegance as the next.
I always say no one knows what they have here, how lucky they are to have such talent here.
And one. Long upper body.
Artistic director Ileana Lopez had hopes that talent would grow even more when they moved into this new, bigger studio off of US 41.
It's all perfect for the kids to dance here.
And then overnight, all of that almost went away.
Oh yeah, that was sad and scary.
It happened last April. A fire started in a nearby storage facility and spread to the studio, causing thousands of dollars in damage.
It was Easter morning.
Trinka Lowe is the ballet's board president.
All of a sudden we had no building. So yeah, it was quite an Easter.
The timing of the fire couldn't have been worse, with the ballet's annual spring performance just weeks away. Gulfshore needed a place to rehearse, and an unlikely group of people were ready to offer it.
I immediately picked up my phone.
I said, when do you need it? Let's make this happen.
Competing studios from Fort Myers.
I even gave Ileana a key so they could just come and go when they needed to use the studio.
To Bonita Springs.
So you kind of have to put that aside, the competition side of it, you know, and just really think about the kids in that situation.
Stepping up when Gulfshore needed it most.
We were just surprised, you know, but very thankful.
The ballet's performance of Don Quixote went on flawlessly, and this month the studio reopened. Ileana says they owe that to the dance community and the decision by many to choose compassion over competition.
It gave us a lot of strength and hope in the future and see that people can help each other when bad things happen. All the way up.
In Fort Myers.
Down.
Sean Martinelli.
Keeping the shoulders down.
NBC2.